When I found out the trip was going to happen, there was nothing else I could think of for a year. I had no idea what to expect. I couldn't even sleep on the plane. All I could do was think of what was to come in the next couple of months. At first, I was surprised by the similarities of the landscapes, but everything else would be a completely different story. We arrived for the first snow of the year, which was nothing new for us. But as the snow melted, the details of the city became exposed. Angers has so much history, melded with an artistic culture full of art and architecture. But cars are everywhere, and just like America, they're transforming dense cities into sprawling suburbs. There are signs of the local quarry everywhere, from the 9th century chateau to the buildings today. Despite the mining at Trélazay moving underground over a century ago, the slate is still produced the same way it has always been. The mounded black slate and deep turquoise water make it a very unique place. Our school, Agro Campus West, had their Expo Flow highlighting the talents of the landscape architecture and horticulture students. With so much to do and see, it is no surprise that France is the most visited country in the world. Paris is one of the largest cities in the world. Despite all of its history and monuments, you never feel that overwhelmed or out of place in the predominantly 5 to 8 story buildings. Despite new urbanist planning, La Défense only sees a fraction of the life the rest of the city does. Paris is alive at all hours of the day, all while boasting some of the most artistic and active parks in the world. Then it was time to get to our first international design workshop in Elvas, Portugal. It was crazy how fast the scenery and culture changed from one country to the next. Is a small castle town in Portugal that boasts Europe's best stargazing. But the aging population is dwindling, and the small town is falling into disrepair. As we headed east, it was as if the world was again turned on its head. The Emscher River in Dortmund had until recently been used as a sewage canal. The main challenge in this workshop was to change people's perceptions of this once dirty place. But the trip wasn't all hard work, and we found time to find it. Everywhere we went, we were studying the cities. What makes them unique, and what makes them work. In the end, there's so much you get from the people, the cities, the parks and open spaces, that you just won't understand from reading a book. Finally, it was time to cross the pond and come back home. This truly was the best time of my life.